Hey there, deep divers. Ever feel like you're your own worst enemy?
Oh, yeah.
Like something's holding you back from really living your best life?
It's a question for the ages.
Totally. And we may not have all the answers, but we've got some interesting stuff from Real Talk with Lady T to dig into. They did an episode about toxic traits.
Well, that one's good. They really got into how these little habits can mess up your happiness in relationships.
So on the show, you've got Lady T, always ready to speak her mind. And her co-host, Mr. Tee-riffic, same deal. And they jump right in by asking, why even bother with this whole self-reflection thing anyway?
Right, like who needs all that introspection?
Exactly. But their answer was really interesting. They said, understanding your toxic traits is like a key. It unlocks a happier and more fulfilling life.
It all starts with seeing these patterns, these little things we all do that might actually be holding us back.
Yeah, and it's not about beating yourself up for having them. It's more like going, oh, hey, there's self-criticism. I see you, but I'm not going to let you run the show today.
Yeah, exactly. Taking control.
So one of the first ones they talked about was self-criticism. I think we've all been there, right? That voice in your head that loves to point out every little flaw.
Ugh. Tell me about it. It's brutal sometimes.
Well, get this. Researchers have actually found that self-criticism lights up the same part of your brain as physical pain.
Wow, really?
Yeah. So you're basically causing yourself real pain with these thought patterns.
So instead of saying like, oh, I'm such a failure, it's more about going, okay, so I messed up this time. What can I learn?
Exactly. Being kinder to yourself. Treat yourself how you would treat a friend.
Right, because nobody talks to their friends like that.
Speaking of relationships, the next toxic trait Lady T and Mr. Tee-riffic brought up was blame shifting.
Oh boy, passing the buck.
Yep. They gave this example. Imagine someone who is always late. And every time it's, oh, sorry, traffic was a nightmare.
And they probably even believe it themselves after a while.
Right. But the real question is, are they owning their part in it? Like, are they willing to actually change their behavior?
And that's the tough part, isn't it? Because blaming others is easy, but it keeps us from growing.
And let's be real, it can really damage relationships. Who wants to be around someone who always blames everyone else for their problems?
Yeah, that gets old last.
So it's about recognizing that real change happens when we take responsibility for our actions, even when it's uncomfortable.
Definitely. And sometimes it takes looking in the mirror to make that happen.
Now, on a lighter note, Lady T and Mr. Tee-riffic talked about another relatable one, jealousy.
Ah, the green-eyed monster.
Right. And these days with social media, it's worse than ever.
Oh, for sure. It's hard to resist comparing yourself when everyone's posting their highlight reel 24/7.
Totally. And Lady T actually admitted that scrolling through Instagram often makes her feel inadequate, even jealous of people she barely knows.
Yeah, I've been there.
But what I found interesting was how she talked about the difference between healthy envy and toxic jealousy.
Oh, tell me more about that.
So she said a little envy can be good, actually. It can push us to go after our goals or try new things. But when it turns into resentment and bitterness, that's when it becomes toxic. It's like they say, comparison is the thief of joy.
Oh, yeah, sure.
And then Mr. Tee-riffic asked this great question. He said, what if instead of letting jealousy eat away at you, you saw other people's successes as inspiration?
Ooh, that's good. Like a positive spin.
Right. Instead of seeing it as a threat, celebrate their wins and use it as fuel for your own journey.
It's about abundance, right? There's enough success to go around.
Exactly. Okay, so are you ready for the next toxic trait on their list?
Hit me with it.
This one can be a bit of a downer, but it's important. They called it out as one of the biggest relationship killers, defensiveness.
Ooh, yeah, that one's tough.
It's like this knee-jerk reaction to protect yourself when you feel attacked.
And there's a reason for it. Our brains are wired to avoid pain.
Yeah.
So when someone criticizes us, our defenses go up.
Like fight or flight, but for our egos. But the thing is, being defensive might protect you in the moment, but it can really hurt your relationships long term.
Because you're not really listening when you're busy defending yourself.
Right. You miss the chance to connect and grow.
So what's the solution? How do you deal with that?
Well, Lady T and Mr. Tee-riffic said to try approaching feedback with an open mind, even if it's not delivered in the nicest way.
That's hard, though.
It is, but try to see it from their point of view. Ask yourself, what can I learn from this instead of instantly going into I'm not wrong mode?
So it's more about listening and learning than defending.
Exactly. And you know what? That actually leads perfectly into the next toxic trait they talked about, perfectionism.
Ah, yes, striving for the impossible.
Right. It sounds good on paper, but they said it can actually lead to a lot of unhappiness.
Because you're never really satisfied, are you? There's always something else to improve or do better.
They actually said perfectionism is the enemy of progress, because when you're so focused on getting everything perfect, you end up procrastinating or giving up entirely.
Yeah, I could see that happening. It's paralyzing.
And Lady T shared this story about how her own perfectionism was holding her back from writing. She was so scared of not being good enough that she wouldn't let anyone read her work.
Wow, that's really sad.
It is, right? So their advice for dealing with perfectionism was to embrace imperfection. Mistakes are just opportunities for growth, not failures.
It's about being kind to yourself.
And speaking of self-compassion, that brings us to the final toxic trait they discussed, negativity.
Ooh, that's a big one.
It can really bring you down,
yeah.
You know? And it's not just about being a downer. Negativity can actually change your brain over time.
Wait, really? How so?
So there's this thing called negativity bias. Our brains are naturally drawn to negative experiences more than positive ones. It's like we're wired to focus on the bad stuff.
Totally. And the more you dwell on those negative thoughts, the stronger those connections get in your brain. It's like practicing being negative, which is not exactly helpful. Yeah.
So how do we break out of that cycle? How do we rewire our brains for the better? What did Lady T and Mr. Tee-riffic suggest?
Well, they're big proponents of practicing gratitude.
Gratitude, like just thinking about things you're grateful for.
Yeah. And it's not about pretending everything's perfect. It's more about actively looking for the good, even when things are tough.
So, like, instead of stressing about a mountain of work, maybe you take a minute to appreciate a nice cup of coffee.
Exactly. Or the sunshine, your family, a funny meme you saw online. It's about shifting your focus.
And the cool thing is, studies show that doing this actually changes your brain over time, like physically rewires it for more positivity.
Yeah, it's not just some feel-good fluff. There's real science behind it.
That's amazing. It feels empowering to know we can actually change how our brains work.
Definitely. It's about taking control of your thoughts instead of letting them control you.
So to recap, we've covered 6 toxic traits: self-criticism, blame shifting, jealousy, defensiveness, perfectionism, and negativity.
Quite a lineup.
It is. But the important thing to remember is that recognizing these traits is just the beginning.
It's a journey, not a destination, right?
Exactly. And that journey might involve things like being kinder to yourself, taking responsibility, being happy for others, being open to feedback, and embracing imperfection.
And of course, practicing gratitude.
It's about recognizing those patterns and making a conscious choice to do things differently.
And that's a powerful place to be.
Absolutely. Well, that about wraps up our deep dive into toxic traits. Hopefully you've gotten some food for thought.
Yeah, it's a lot to think about.
Definitely. But remember, it's not about being perfect. It's about being a little bit better every day. And who knows, maybe by recognizing these patterns, we can actually become our own best allies.
No, that's a goal worth striving for.
Couldn't agree more. And on that note, we'll leave you to continue your own journey of self-discovery. Until next time, keep those conversations flowing.